Yes, in this video, we are going to see how the page table can be stored in the main memory. In the previous videos, what we have seen is if the number of pages of a particular process is less than 256 entries, then it is better to use the registers, system CPU registers. In that case, it will be more efficient because we can avoid the two memory access, one for the page table and one for the frame number, or that is one for the page table entry and another for the frame number. Whereas if it is above 256, if a particular page table has more entries, more than 256, if the user's that is logical address space is large, then it is not possible to use the registers in the CPU. So better what we have to do is we have to store the page table itself in the main memory. That is what we have seen. See, for example, this page table itself, we have to store it in the main memory. So in that case, how we are going to manage that page table? Suppose if the page table entry is very big, if the page table itself is very big, how we are going to store it? So there are three techniques which are followed. One is hierarchical paging, hashed page tables, and inverted page tables. First, in this video, we'll be seeing the hierarchical paging. So what happens when the page table is bigger than the frame? If you have to store the page table in this main memory, you can store it only as a frame by frame. But if the frame, suppose the frame size is 4 KB and the page table size is 4 GB, what will happen? It cannot be stored in one frame. So the frame is smaller than the page table, but you cannot store because the page table cannot be stored in one frame. In that case, what you have to do, you have to split the page table into pages, and that only you can store it in the frames of the main memory. So now we are going to see how to do that. So break up the logical address space into multiple page tables. Here we use a simple technique called two-level paging, and more than that also is that if the user space is more, the logical address space is very big, then the page table entry also will be more, in which case we will go for three-level page table also. Now I'll explain this with a small a simple example. So when the page table size is larger than the frame number, we cannot allocate in one frame. We cannot allocate a single contiguous space for this. You cannot allocate a continuous space also, frame 1, frame 2, frame 3. That also is not possible because the paging itself is that which wherever the frame is free, there we will put. But anyway, it has to maintain the continuity of that page table. So now we will see how we are going to do that. So two-level paging is one method where page table itself is page. The page table itself is divided into page, and that itself we are going to keep it in the frame. For that, we will keep one more page table so that which page table is in which frame. For that itself, we have to keep another page table. So that is what we are going to see. Let us see this example. The size of the page table, why the need for multi-level paging? When the size of the page table becomes greater than the frame size, say for example, if this is the logical address space and this is the physical address space, if the page size is 4 KB, okay? So here, if you say 4 GB, it comes out, this logical address space, let us consider the page size is 4 KB, so that so many pages are there. The logical address space itself is 4 GB. Now, already we have seen that frame size and page size should be equal. That is, here it is 4 KB means here also it should be 4 KB. So in this 4 KB, how your 4 GB, there are so many entries. When you see 4 GB, it will come around many entries in a page table. We will see that logic. So that itself become more than 4 KB. That cannot be put in one frame. So now, the size of the page table is greater than the frame size. One frame cannot accommodate one single page table. As a result, The page table cannot be stored in a single frame in main memory. The page table having size greater than the frame size, now you have to divide it. There is no other page. You have to divide it according to the page size and then put that in the frame. So the size of each part is same as the frame, each page is same as the frame size, except possibly the last part, the one which you are dividing the last. The pages of the page table, if you are going to create a page table, the pages of the page table are then stored in different frames of the main memory. So to keep track of the frames, storing the pages of the divided page table, another page table has to be maintained. As a result, a hierarchy of page table within another page table has to be done. So as a simple example, I'll explain. Consider a system using the paging scheme where this is what? That is, logical address space is 4GB. Let us consider a user process, a logical address space to be 4GB, which is nothing but when you express in terms of 2 power, it is nothing but 2 power 32. So that much entry, when you say 2 power 32 means 32 entries, that is 2 power 32 entries will be there. Okay, 2 power 32 is nothing but 4GB. Now physical address space, let us take a physical address space is 16TB, which is 2 power 44. So it requires 44 bits to address each and individual line in this, whereas here it requires 32 bits. So the logical address space consists of 32 bits, whereas the physical address consists of 44 bits. So the number of bits, the physical address is 44 bits, and the page size given is 4KB. So already we know the strict rule that page size and frame size should be equal. So 4K, it is, when it is equal to 4KB, the frame size also is equal to 4KB. So this is the problem given. Now we'll see how we are going to form the page table and how we are going to keep the page table in this physical memory. Because the page table is very big, so it cannot be kept in the register. So that point is ruled out. So when that is ruled out, where we have to keep the page table? We have to keep it in the main memory only. The process, user process is also in the main memory, as well as the page table also will be in the main memory. So number of frames, let us first calculate the number of frames. You have to keep this as a frames. So how you can find out? By dividing the 16TB, that is this memory, by the frame size, which is nothing but 4KB. Already we have seen page size is 4KB, so frame size is also 4KB. So 16TB is equal to 2 power 44. This divided by 2 power 12 will give 2 power 32 frames. So 2 power 32 frames will be there. That means one frame number, there are 2 power 32 frames are there. Okay, so one frame number, frame bit, frame number, if you want to represent one frame, say one frame, two frame, three frame, the one frame itself will consist of 4KB. Okay, so one, in order to represent that one frame, then another frame, we need 32 bits. That's what. So that is why it is 2 power 32 frames. 2 power 32 frames are there in this when you divide it. So thus the number of bits in the frame number will be 32. You need 32 bits to uniquely identify each and every frame in this physical address space. Now, the number of bits in the page offset. Now, how you will find the page offset? That is, within that, how you will represent individual elements. So, the page size is 4KB, which you can represent as 2 power 12. That is, so this page, if you represent this as a page, all this number of that each within that page, offset is the line within that page. So, you need 12 bits. So number of bits in the page offset is 12 bits. So put together, you have 44 bits. So frame number and page offset. If the page number is 1, then within that, which line? For that, you need 12 bits. Okay, individual line. So put together, you have 44 bits. 44 bits are needed in order to uniquely identify a address in the 16TB. So this is the logic. So far, I have explained. Now, number of pages of the process. We have already seen number of frames, which is nothing but 2 power 32 frames. Okay, so number of bits in the page offset also we have seen, that is within the frame, particular line can be addressed with the 12 bit. That we call it as page offset. Okay, now how many pages within this that we will be studying. So number of pages of the process, already we have seen the user process is 4GB. So how you can find how many pages? That divided by single page size, so which is nothing but 4 KB. So 4GB equal to 4 by 32, which divided by 2 per 12 will give 2 by 20 pages. So 2 by 20 pages are there. So when you say 2 by 20 pages, and each page will have one entry in the page table, means which is nothing but 2 by 20 entries are there. Here 2 by 20 pages are there. Within that pages you have so many lines. Okay, so each page consists of 4 KB. So when there are 2 by 20 pages itself is there, each page consists of one entry in the page table, means this will consist of 2 by 20 entries. Okay, this is the page table, man. This is the page table for this user process, and it is of type nothing but 4 MB. 2 by 20 into, why it is 4 MB? 2 by 20 is the number of entries. Then within that frame number, this is page 1, page 2, page 3, and so on up to 2 by 20. So within that page, what is the, this page is mapped to which frame number? So frame number is represented by 32 bits, which we have already seen here. So this 32 bits. So 2 by 20, then within that 32 bits. So that is what given here, 2 by 20 to 32 bits, 4 bytes, which is nothing but given like this. When so by 4 MB, here it consists of 4 MB data, which is nothing but 2 by 22. So here, this into 4 bytes. Okay. So you have this value 2 by 22. So the total space is 2 by 22. Now we can observe, when you say this is 4 MB, whereas this is page size is 4 KB. And so if here it is 4 KB, then in physical memory also the frame should be of size 4 KB only. Whereas here you can see that in order to store the, this has been divided into pages, and that can be those, each page entry is here, one page, second page, third. So number of pages 220, 2 by 20. So 2 by 20 entries are there along with that frame number, that is the, each consists of 32 bits each page. So put together we have 4 MB, the size of this itself 4 MB, whereas the page size is 4 KB and frame size is 4 KB. Clearly it indicates that page table is more than one frame, that is it is greater, 4 MB is greater than the 4 KB. So this cannot be put in one frame. In order, so what we have to do, we have to divide this page table itself into different pages, which must be of equal size of the frame. So what happened, we have to page this also, we have to divide this as this page table itself as further page. So how we can divide that? Number of pages of the inner page table. How first you have to find out how many pages are there. So naturally page size must be 4 KB. So we divide the size of this 4 MB divided by 4 KB, which is nothing but 4 MB divided by, which is nothing but 2 by 10. So 1024 pages. So so now you can divide this into number of pages, which gives 2 by 22 by 2 by 12, which is nothing but 2 by 10 pages, which is nothing but 1024 pages here itself. If you divide this 1024, which means 1024 frames are needed for keeping this page table alone. Okay, so they, now these, since we have size is this 2 by 10 pages of inner page table are stored in different frames of the main memory. Now we are going to keep, now it is equal, okay, it is lesser than the frame size. That was only 1024 pages. It is, each page is divided into this is divided into 1024 pages. Now we have to keep this in 1024, but the page table itself is splitted in different pages, in different frames. In order to keep track, we have to create one more table where this page table entry will be there, and in which frame this particular page table. Already I told you this itself is a page table. Now we are dividing this page table into pages and we put it in frame. So the for example, the 1024 pages are there. So fifth page table, let us imagine some fifth page table, fifth page of this page table. The fifth page, if it is placed in the 10th frame, then that has to be kept in some other page table, saying that the fifth page of this is kept in the 10th frame, like that. So for that, we need one more page table. So how we can do that? Number of pages of the inner page table we have already found as to be 1024 pages. Number of page table entries in the in one page. So in one page, how many entries? If you take one page, the total page is 1024. But in one page, how many entries? That can be again find out by 2KB is nothing but that is 4KB is the page size divided by number of bits in the frame number. If you do this, take this formula divided by 32, now you will get 1024. So in one page, if you take this, if you divide it into 1024 pages, in one page you will be having 1024 entries. Now number of bits required to search an entry in one page table is nothing but, if you take this inner page table, then you need 2^10 bits. So 10 bits are needed to access each page, because there are 1024 pages we are going to divide. Okay, so for that we need 10 number of bits. In order to search one page in an inner page table, you need 10 bits. Outer page table size. So now we come to the outer page, where we keep the information that which page table is kept in which frame. Okay, now I am talking in terms of page table, not page. The page table is divided into different pages, which is again a page table. So each page itself is a page table that we are going to keep it in the main memory in a particular frame. So which page of the page table is kept in which frame? That has to be kept, that is kept in the outer page table. So how to keep, how to find out that? The outer page table is required to keep track of the frames storing the pages of the inner page table. So how you can find out? The number of pages, the inner page table is divided by number of bits in the frame number. So that can be found out by 2^10, which is nothing but the number of pages in the inner table by 32. So you totally will be getting 2^12. Now we can observe, which is nothing but 4KB. So now we can observe the size of the outer page table is same as the frame size. Now it is, now we are ready to put the page. We have divided the page table into correct page size, which is equal to the frame size of the physical memory. So in order to access this outer page also, we need 2^10 entries because of the 1024 entry. Okay, because of this 1024, because the outer page table also will consist of 2^10 entries only. So now if you see this here, the this is the page table based register. This gives the from CPU generates the logical address. The page table based address will consist of the base address of this outer page table, and this is the inner page table, and this is the main memory. So in main memory we will store the pages of the page table. Okay, so here if you see that the inner page table will consist of a 32 bits. What do you mean by this 32 bits? Each individual, that is 32 bits is required for frame. Say this is the first frame, second frame, third frame, fourth frame, and so on, for representing that 32 bits, because the size of the main memory is 16 TB, that is 2^44. Within 2^44, 32 is for identifying the frames, and 12 bits are. So with this, we'll see how with an example we'll see how this can be done. Here this is a main memory. Let us imagine this is a main memory, which is nothing but our 16 TB, the example what we have taken. And here this is to be inner page table, and this is the outer page table. So here this page table size itself is 4MB, which means each page is of size 4KB. Okay, this is one page, This is second page, third page, fourth page, and so on till the 4 MB. That is what we have seen here. 41,94,304 address. That will be the last address in this. Want us, I can't enter all those things. So just a sample I have entered here. So that much entries will be, 4 MB entries will be in this. Whereas each page will consist of 4 KB, which is nothing but 2 power 12. So each page, this is one page, that itself will, that page size is 4 KB. And here the frame size is also 4 KB. So that the 0th page can be kept here, first page can be kept in the another frame, and that frame information can be entered here. So this itself is one page table. This is a page table. The whole thing is a page table. So now what we are doing is we are dividing this into pages. That's what we have seen in the previous one. That is inner page table. Number of pages in the how you can calculate. That is 4 MB. This is size of this is 4 MB divided by each page. So we will get 1024 pages. That is what has been given. So this is nothing but for reference purpose I have entered here. 0 to 1024 pages. This itself, if you divide the page table itself into pages. Okay. So in one page, 1024 entry will be there. Like that. If you take 1025 to 2048, there are 1024 pages. Page entries. Not actually page, it is page entries. So this page is present in where? That frame number will be there. Already we have seen frame number is of 32 bits. And because of this 1024, this can be represented by 10 bits. Okay. So now this 0th page, this is divided into pages. This whole page table is divided into 1024 pages. The page table itself is an indication of where the particular page is present in which frame. The 0th frame is present in 5. But all these things together form one page. Likewise, we have divided and we get 1024 pages in the page table alone, where each page size is of, this page size is of 4 KB. Okay. So, sorry, not 4 KB, up to 1024, that is 2 power 10. Whereas, here this page number, page is equal to 4 KB of where it is equal to the frame number. Now, here we have to pay, we have to keep, already we know that we are going to keep the page table itself in the main memory. But, see, because of this bigger data, that is, this itself is 4 MB, we can't allocate into a single frame. That is why we are splitting the page table also as pages. Okay, so that we can keep this is split into 4 KB, which is of the same size as the frame. Now we have to keep this. Say for example, we want to keep this here. This is a one page. If you read the page table, this becomes one page. This page table information itself is we are keeping one frame, another frame, and so on. So when we keep all these things here, then so for example, this 0th page, this whole thing is present in this frame, that is 5th frame. Then in 6th frame, 1025, this is present, that is this first frame is first of page of this page table is kept. Let us imagine now. How to keep track the page table itself? Because after this, then this will be the next page. After this, then this will be the next page table. How to keep track? For that, we have the outer page table where again we have numbered that consists of 1024 entries where 5 is the this page. It indicates page of this page table. Then 3 is the page of this page table. And so it point to this. From here, it will get the frame number. So if you see this, this is the outer page table, which is 1024. 1024 entries can be represented by 10 bits. That is 2 power 10. So with that, you can say which is the, from that entry, you can find out the page number that can be extracted. Then 10 bits. So taking that page number, you can hash, you can map this to this page table, but this is also will be placed in the main memory only, and where this is less than a frame, that is 1024 entries only, so it can be kept in one frame. Then suppose it is going here, now let us take 5, then 5 we have to go to this, and here we have 1024 entries. So for that you have 10 bits, again 2 power 10. So from this, which is the entry that can be taken from this 10 bits, then offset is within that page. So for example, 1025th page, let us take 1025th bit, or for easy reference, let me take the first page. If it is placed here, the from the first page, the one page may consist of 4 KB data. So which is the line within that page, that is called offset. So that can be is nothing but 12 bits is the offset. So from this, 10 bit is used to find out outer page table, where the inner page table, inner page number can be taken, and both together, combined together, it helps to find out the exact, that is, it is used to extract the frame number from this. So that's what we have kept the frame number here. From this, frame number is nothing but where it is based on the main number that can be extracted, and then together it forms 32 bits. It is 10 bits. Here, frame number is nothing but 32 bits. So that 32 bit is extracted, displaced, and from this offset. So within that frame number, which line or which address that is given in the 12 bits, and the main memory is. From the main memory, the particular page has been exactly first particular frame is extracted, and then within that frame number, what is the line going to be executed, that can be taken from this 12 bits.